Breathing land, I knew the pathway like the back of my head. I felt the earth beneath my feet, set by a river, and it made me everything. So why don't we go? once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond the illusion. I was soaring ever higher, but I flew too high. Though my eyes could see, I still was a blind man. Though my mind could think, I still was a madman. I hear the voices when I'm dreaming. I can hear them say, carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more. Masquerading as a man with a reason, my charade is the event of the season. And if I claim to be a wise man, it surely means that I don't know. On a stormy sea of moving emotion, tossed about him like a ship on the ocean. I set a course for winds of fortune, but I hear the voices say, carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more.
Thank you all so much. We are the Sons of Serendip, finalists on season 9 of America's Got Talent, and contestants on the first ever America's Got Talent, the champions. And I have a question for you guys. Are you guys ready to rock? Well, if you're ready to rock, then you came to the wrong show. Oh my gosh. We have a harp, a cello, a keyboard. Ready to rock? What? So, nonetheless, we are so blessed to be here tonight in Saratoga Springs at the historic Caffè Lena. This is the first time that we've ever performed here, and wow, 2 sold-out concerts. This is really exciting for us. Thank you, yeah. But quick question though. One, we're gonna be doing this is the last concert of the night, so it'll be a 3-hour set. Get it. But we'll be doing one long set instead of, because normally we do two separate, you know, with an intermission. So, but tonight will be one long set. So that just means that I just have to hold my urine just a little bit longer than normal. Quick question though. How many of you all saw us on America's Got Talent? All right, awesome. How many of you voted for us on America's Got Talent? One, two, three, four. You don't look sure. 4.5. Hmm. 5.5? Okay, 5.5 people. To those 5.5 people, thank you so, so much. Thank you. And to the rest of you, you all should be ashamed of yourselves. Absolutely ashamed, but we'll talk more about that later on. One thing that we like to do at the beginning of all of our concerts, we would love for you all to take a look at the people around you and tell the people around you that it is so good to see you here tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you. Perfect. Because every moment that we have to share with one another is a gift, and we don't take that for granted. So are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
So tonight will be a mixture of songs that you know, songs that you may not know, as well as original material. We're also gonna be sprinkling in some storytelling as well along the way. It's gonna be a good night. I can feel the energy. This next song actually has an interesting story behind it that I'll share with you. So our first performance as Sons of Serendip was July of 2014. And it was at a nursing home. And it was by far, and I mean by far, the most difficult performance we've ever had. Ever. Ever. And it was difficult for three reasons. The first reason, I had just bought all this brand new equipment, a new keyboard, a new microphone, a new amplifier, because I was so excited about this journey that we were going on together as a group. We get to the gig, I have the keyboard, I have the microphone, I have the amplifier, but I forgot all the chords at home. So thankfully Cordero brought a child's keyboard as a backup, and they had a karaoke machine there. And so I sang my heart out on that karaoke machine, and Cordero played his heart out on that child's keyboard, and it was awful. Absolutely awful. The second reason, they wanted an hour-long concert. I don't know if you know this, on America's Got Talent, all we do are 90-second versions of the songs. So at that time, all we knew were 90-second versions of the songs. And so we thought, no problem, we'll extend the songs out a little bit. I'm sure we're gonna be able to fill in an hour. 30 minutes in, we ran out of material. So Cordero started juggling. I started doing magic tricks. And Mason started dancing with a woman that didn't want to dance. And Kendall was just back there smiling. It was a circus. Awful. Awful. The third reason. The entire front row was completely passed out and snoring. And the louder I sang, the louder they snored. And I thought, is this really what I want to do with my life? It is, but at that time I definitely questioned it. Nonetheless, we took the money that we made that day, and to celebrate, we went out to McDonald's. And we got our Happy Meals, and we ran out to the car, and we began to dream. We began to dream about what we hope to see in our future as Sons of Serendip. And one of the things that came up that night was that one day, we wanted the opportunity to perform with orchestras. Fast forward exactly 1 year later, and this next song is a song that we performed with the Boston Pops for the 4th of July celebration in Boston, Massachusetts. And we do the song at all of our concerts because it reminds us that dreams really do come true.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't fear the fall. Hope when the water rises, you give it all. Hope when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. I hope that you fall in love, and it hurts so bad. The only way you can know is give it all you have. But I hope that you don't suffer, but take the pain. I hope when your moment comes, you'll say, I did it all. I did it all. I owned every second that this this world could give. Saw so many places, the things that I did. Yeah, with every broken bone, I swear I live. I hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. Hope you raise your cup. I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. Until my moment comes, I'll say, I did it second that this world could give. Saw so many places, the things that I did. Yeah, with every broken bone, I swear I live.
Wanted to give a quick shout out to Ron. Happy birthday, Ron, and thank you for being here. This next song is a Stevie Wonder tune.
Street. you never notice me. My shirt anymore. Tell me how it is you could ignore that behind that little smile I wore. How I wish that you were mine. La 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 la.
Maybe someday you'll see my face among the crowd. Maybe someday I'll share your little distant cloud. Oh, my Serendip, pretty little one that I adore. You're the only girl my heart beats for. How I wish that you were tell you a little bit about the group. First off, we're not a basketball team. And I say that because we showed up to Madison Square Garden. There are two events that are happening at the same time. There's a basketball event, and there are the America's Got Talent auditions. Mason had his harp. And we're heading over to the America's Got Talent auditions. Mason had his harp. And the security guard comes over and she's like, "Sorry, fellas, but the basketball game is over that way." Mason had his harp. So no, we're not a basketball team. Second thing, our name, Sons of Serendip. We've been called every name in the book. Sons of Serendip, Sons of Honey Dip, Sons of Champagne, Sons of Chardonnay. Some guy came up to us and he's like, "Hey, you guys are the Sons of Serengeti." And we're like, "No." So let me hear you guys. Sons of Serendip.
Sons of Serendip.
Perfect. So a little bit more about the group. We met at Boston University while in graduate school. And are there some BU grads that are here? Okay, awesome, perfect. And after we graduated, we went our separate ways. We're doing different things. And then in 2014, on a whim, we sent an audition tape to America's Got Talent, and it completely changed our lives. What I'm gonna do, though, is introduce you to the different members of the group and tell you just a little bit about what each member did before we came together as Sons of Serendip. So first off, on the harp, we have Mason Morton. Mason is originally from Atlanta, Georgia. He has his master's in harp performance. He's been influenced by the music of Ravel and the harpist Ann Hobson Pilot. And before becoming a part of Sons of Serendip, Mason was a performer with orchestras and a middle school teacher. Let's give it up for Mason. On the cello, we have Kendall Ramsour. Kendall is originally from Charlotte, North Carolina. He has his master's in cello performance. He's been influenced by the music of Hans Zimmer, John Williams, and Yo-Yo Ma. And before becoming a part of Sons of Serendip, Kendall was a solo performer and a teacher. Let's give it up for Kendall. And one interesting thing about Kendall is that he and his wife Yolanda just welcomed in their first baby boy, Owen Benjamin Ramsour. On the keyboard, we have Cordero Rodriguez. Cordero is also from Charlotte, North Carolina. These guys actually grew up on the same block and were good friends growing up, and then reunited serendipitously at Boston University. Cordero has a law degree. He's been influenced by the music of Hans Zimmer, the composer Yanni, and gospel music. And before becoming a part of Sons of Serendip, Cordero was a lawyer. My name is Micah Christian. I am from Boston, Massachusetts. I've been influenced by Bobby McFerrin, India Ari, and Karen Carpenter. And before becoming a part of Sons of Serendip, I taught English. So as I mentioned, in 2014, on a whim, we sent in an audition tape to America's Got Talent. They called us back 3 weeks later and asked us if we wanted to audition in front of the judges for television. After we were done running around the house, screaming and jumping for joy, we said, sure, why not? And our lives completely changed. We ended up placing fourth that season. And since then, we've been traveling, thank you. And since then, we've been traveling all over this beautiful country, performing for lovely audiences like yourselves. Not as awesome, but for lovely audiences like yourselves. And so every moment that we have to share the music that we love with audiences like you, we don't take that for granted. So thank you so much for having us here tonight, and thank each and every one of you for showing up. Thank you.
I lay
side. But if you love me, why'd you leave me? Take my body, take my body. we fight, but I'ma love you still. You hint, I spill. We lie, but I'ma love you still. You hurt, I heal. We cry, but I'ma love you still. You bail, I dwell when we try, so I'ma love you still. But we trust, so I'ma love you still. You'll call my rage enough, but I'ma love you still. Your skin I've shed too much, but will you love me still?
Thank you. So those last two songs that you heard were originals. Thank you. The first one was an original collaborative, an instrumental collaborative called First Steps. And the last song that you heard was Love You Still, written by Cordero Rodriguez. So, quick story. My parents, growing up, used to do things that we were told black people don't do. For example, camping. We went camping. Skiing. We went skiing. And I was the only one in my family that absolutely hated it. Hated it. And does anyone here like skiing? Okay, all right, cool. What about you guys? You guys like skiing? You love it? Yeah, Mason said he loves it. Yeah. So, my first time skiing or going to the ski resort, I was an awkward 11-year-old, 5'7", size 15 shoe. We showed up to the ski resort. We were in line, and I remember my brothers were in the line, and they were going up, and you know, sir, I need some skis and some ski poles. And the guy's like, all right, what size do you wear? And he's like, I wear a 6. All right, here you go. Here's your skis, here's your ski poles. I'm like, thank you, sir. And my other brother goes up. He's like, sir, I need some skis and a ski pole, whatever. And he's like, what size do you wear? I wear a 7. All right, here you go. No problem. I go up there. He's like, all right, what size do you wear? I was like, a 15. And he looked at me. And he goes, son, with shoes like that, you don't need skis. All you need are the poles. It's terrible. And then my other problem is that my feet, I have duck feet, so they go out like that. And when I try to stop, I go faster. So it's just like, it's awful. So when I do have kids, I don't have them yet, but when I do, and they ask me, hey, Dad, can we go skiing? I'm like, no. Black people don't ski. This next song is one for the, what, 5.5 people, or is it 4.5 people that saw us in America's Got Talent? You heard this song. There was a time I used to look into my father's eyes in a happy home. I was a king, I had a golden throne. Those days are gone, now the memory's on the wall. I still hear the song, this is where I was born. Upon a hill across a blue lake, that's where I had my first heartbreak. I still remember how it all changed. My father said, don't you worry, child. See, heaven's got a plan for you. Don't you worry now.
Think of her now and then. Balsam Blue Lake. That's where I had my first heartbreak. I still remember how it all changed. My father said, don't you worry, child. See, heaven's got a plan for you. Don't you worry now.
Now, we're gonna need you guys to sing along. Are you ready to sing?
Yes!
Are you ready to sing?
Yes!
There we go. All right, I'm gonna split you all up into two parts, split you in half. So this half of the room, you're gonna do this part right here. Don't you worry. Don't you worry. Don't you worry. Don't worry, you can do it. Don't you worry. Don't you worry. All right, let me hear you.
Don't you worry.
That's nice. Doesn't have to be good, just has to be loud.
Don't you worry.
Perfect, keep that going. Perfect, keep that going. This half of the room is your part.
Don't you worry.
Don't you worry, child.
Don't you worry,
child. Don't you worry, child.
Don't you worry,
child.
Keep that going, keep that going.
Don't you worry, child.
This next song is an original, and it has an interesting story behind it that Kendall is going to share with you.
All right, you guys enjoying the show? Awesome, awesome. So as Mike has said, this next piece has an interesting story, and I would love to share it with you guys. So travel with me. The year is 2012, and Cordero and I had just graduated from Boston University. I had received my master's in cello performance, and Cordero had received his law degree. So after graduating, one I should say, we were super excited to have graduated, right? But we finally had this opportunity to figure out what we could offer the world after getting these. Let's see, mine was, it was really big, it was bold print, it was bright red. Super expensive degrees we paid so much money for. So during that particular season, three members of the quartet, we were roommates, okay? And so Cordero was one of my roommates, and we would link up from time to time in order to brainstorm and think, to figure out, we have this little transitional period. What can we do to generate some income? So we would brainstorm and think. And we soon found out that brainstorming and thinking, they're great things to do, but it will not pay your bills. So we had to come up with a plan, and Cordero had this plan. He said, how about we go into the subways of Boston and we busk? You guys know what busking is? Of course, right. Okay, so let's see. For those who don't, this is what it looks like. You take your instrument. For us, it was the cello. Cordero also plays the guitar. And you take a basket, okay? You go into the subways, you set up, and you play. And you hope that folks enjoy your music enough that they'll chip in a few dollars. So that's the idea. So we had the cello, we had the guitar. We didn't have a basket, so we used a spaghetti strainer. So this was his grand plan. I was very much against this idea. I'm a classically trained cellist, maybe a little bougie, I don't know. But, you know, I'm used to performing in beautiful places like this, but you're asking me now to go into a subway where it's noisy, people are running around and screaming, and then there's like the occasional rodent just like scurrying about. So I wasn't feeling the idea, but Cordero, being the trained lawyer that he is, he made his case, he won, and we were down in the subway. So we get down there, cello, guitar, spaghetti strainer. Environment's exactly what I thought it would be. It was noisy, people were running around and screaming, and the rodents were there waiting. But nonetheless, we sat up, and we began to play. So we were working through the music, and I must admit, it was a huge challenge for me. I was used to playing music by reading it. But down there, we were doing all improv, meaning we were creating these songs in the moment. So we worked through that day's worth of music, and we packed up, and then we started walking back home. And on the way back, I was complaining. I was given every reason under the sun of why I felt like we didn't need to go back down there. But Cordero, you know, Boston University trained him pretty well. So we ended up going back down there the next day. So we're down there, same situation. We set up, and we begin to play, working through the music. And I remember he started playing this beautiful chord progression on the guitar. And I sat there and I was like, man, this is really nice. Let me see what I can come up with on the cello. So we were playing and playing. And all of a sudden, I recognized that the atmosphere in the subway changed. Those people that were yelling and screaming, they began to lower their voices, and then they would come and they would stand around us. Those folks that were running, trying to catch their train, they would run, slow down, and stop. And then they would turn, and they would come and stand around us. I remember there was a point in the music when I looked up, and there were 60, 70 people standing all around us. And there was a lady standing to my right. I noticed that a tear began to fall. And from my recollection, it even seemed like the rodents even stopped scurrying, and they were listening. And then there was another lady across the track. She was there dancing for joy. I looked over to Cordero and I said, you know what? I think we found a piece that resonates with hearts. So since then, we brought this piece from the depths of the earth, and we auditioned Mike on the cajon, and along with Mason, each member has been able to bring something very special to this piece that we call D major, and we hope that you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you all so much. This next song is going to be the last song of the concert, but we wanted to thank Caffè Lena for having us here tonight. Thank you to the sound engineers, the lighting crew, to the hospitality, to the Buffalo Bills for losing so that you all could be here. Kidding, I'm kidding. Patriots lost too. Terrible. But thank you to everyone that it took to make tonight possible, and thank each and every one of you for showing up. Thank you, guys. You all really helped to make 2020 off to a great start, so we're really grateful to you all. So, a couple of things. We're on social media. We're on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. If you're interested in following our journey, you can follow us there. You know what? Just so that we know that everyone in the room made it home safely, as soon as you get home, just go on Facebook and make sure that the post is public and just say, I made it home safely. Will you do that for us? Awesome. So a couple more things. We've recorded 3 albums since we've been a group. And those albums are available out back or out front. And we would love for you all to check those out on your way out, especially for those of you who forgot to vote for us while we were on America's Got Talent. And just so you know, none of the proceeds will be going to any of the members of the group. But they're going to be going to our student loans, especially that guy back there. This next song is another Stevie Wonder tune.
Like a fool, I went and stayed too long. Now I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Then that time I went and said goodbye. Now I'm back and not ashamed to cry.
To sing along for one last time. Are you ready to sing?
Yeah.
There we go. And remember, it doesn't have to be good, just has to be perfect. So I'm gonna split you up into three parts. This first part is for this, ooh, yeah, ooh, here we go, ooh, three parts, yeah. This first part is for this section right over here.
Signed, sealed, delivered. Signed, sealed, delivered. Signed, sealed, delivered.
All right, let me hear you.
Signed, sealed, delivered.
Perfect. Keep that going. Next part's for this section over here.
Here I am, baby. Here I am, baby. Here I am, baby. Here I am, baby.
All right, let me hear you. Let me hear you. Even louder. Perfect. Keep that going. You guys want one more song? All right, we'll do it here. Saratoga Springs, holy moly. Thank you. Oh, we would love to. We would love to. All right, so after the concert, we're gonna be out near, I might have mentioned, I can't remember, but we'll be out near the CD table. We would love for you all to come by and say hello on your way out. Thank you. You all have been a wonderful, wonderful audience, and this has been a very special night for us, especially our first time in Caffè Lena. First time. This is wonderful. Hope so. So before we go on to the very, very last song of the concert, I'm going to share a story with you that we would love for you all to take with you as you head out this evening. Back in college, I read a poem that had a profound impact on my life. This poem was by a poet named Linda Ellis. And in this poem, Linda asked the question, "What is the most important item on a tombstone?" To answer that, many of us would say that it is the name or the message or the date of birth or the date of passing. But in this poem, she says it's none of these things, but it's that little dash between the date of birth and the date of passing. This little dash encompasses so much. Love shared, memories made, moments of pain and lasting peace. Moments of tears and lasting joy. Moments of weakness and lasting strength. And it represents all the people that we've had an impact on along the way during our everyday journey. And it represents all the people that have helped to mold and develop us into who we are and who we ultimately become. This dash, this little dash, represents life. Life. A mentor of mine was recently told that he had a short time to live by doctors. And I asked him, how has that impacted the way that you experience and live out your dash? And he said this. He said, Micah, I am more present now than I've ever been in all my life. Now, when I laugh, I laugh. When I cry, I cry. And when I hug, I hug. And when I say I love you, I mean and I feel every word. And when I breathe, and he took a deep breath in, and he said, I breathe. Friends, with all that's going on in the world, it is so easy to lose touch with just how precious this life is. And it's so easy to forget that every moment that we have to share with one another is a gift. It's a gift. And so we hope that when you leave here tonight, that you feel a little bit more present, that you feel just a little bit more alive, and that when you laugh, you'll laugh. And when you cry, you'll cry. And when you hug, you will hug and feel that embrace. And when you say, I love you, you will mean and you feel every word. And when you breathe, this last song that we're going to do tonight is Hallelujah by Leonard Cohen. And we would love for everyone here in this space to sing along during the chorus. Thank you again for being such a beautiful audience and for sharing this moment with us. We do hope we see you again in the future. And we love you. Thank you.
heard there was a secret chord David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah.
Trying to touch, I've told the truth. I